hello to all my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, new fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine, doing my 11th Talking Machine show. I have a great guest, and she has something to do with horses, which is close to my heart. And I'm going to let her introduce herself right now.
Thanks, Al. It's a pleasure to be here, and thanks for inviting me to be here.
You're welcome.
It's wonderful. I'm Ann Davis. I'm the executive director and founder of Horses with Hope. We operate an equine therapy center here in the South Hills.
No, that is great. And you've even been on the show BPTV.
We have, yes.
I heard you have two shows. I only knew there was one, so I got nothing on Ann. I don't even know where to start, but I'll ask, where did you grow up?
So I was born in Mount Lebanon, and then our family moved to Bethel Park when I turned 5 years old. I'm the youngest of 11 kids.
11 kids,
11
wow.
Kids. Yeah, a lot of fun.
No, that is great. You want to shout out to any of your family or anything?
All of them. Say hi, everybody. Look, the baby.
What number are you? The baby?
I'm the baby, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, the baby.
No, so, that is great.
Yeah, it's a great family. Really wonderful brothers and sisters. We all get along, and everybody's healthy, so.
Knock on wood, that
That's
is
right.
great with
That's
these crazy
right.
times. So,
it is, yeah.
And by the way, Bethel Park has mandated that we wear masks because of the rising Delta variant. Even though I've had my booster and others have had their vaccines, we need to be protected and safe. No opinion, but I want to stay alive. You all know I've had a kidney transplant, mm-hmm. so I'm at high risk. So I'm honored to be able to do a great show with the 11th child from a good mother and father. So we'll get this thing going on. You already clued in one of my questions. You grew up in Bethel Park.
I did, yes.
And you graduate from Bethel Park?
Well, actually, kind of a long, short story or whatever.
Well, we're trying to find out about you because I'm promoting good people in
good
our
people,
area.
Good people, yeah.
So lay it on us. So we can handle whatever you tell
handle,
us.
You can handle it? Are you sure?
Even if you didn't go to ninth grade. We understand
right,
that.
Right, exactly.
And even if
yeah.
you skipped 12th grade, we're good.
That's all good.
Yes.
No, I did. I completed high school, but my mother passed away when I was 12.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So, so then the family kind of split up a little bit, and I ended up in Colorado. And
oh my goodness, so you left Bethel Park after 12 years old.
Yeah, well, I was still here. I moved to Burgettstown, to a farm out in Burgettstown.
I know Burgettstown.
I was about 17
yes.
or so, and then I moved to Colorado, and I was away for close to 30 years.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, yeah.
No, so I'm assuming you even told me you didn't go to college, so you went to Colorado. What did you do out there?
So I worked for the airlines.
Okay.
I was in the airline industry for about 20 years.
Nice.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun, a lot of traveling, a lot of...
Sure, if you enjoyed traveling, that's the place to be.
It is, definitely.
Can you say what airline you worked for?
Well, I started out with a commuter airline called Aspen Airways. They're based out of Denver, Colorado.
Okay.
I was in Durango, Colorado.
Okay. I've been to the airport in Colorado one time on a layover. I had to go there, so...
Did you, in Denver?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
The new one, the DIA?
Yes.
Looks like a big tent.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sprawling airport.
And it has all kind of artwork and other things in there. It's
it
amazing.
It is. Yeah, it's a beautiful airport. Yeah. And then after that, I went with Frontier Airlines.
Okay. I've heard of them.
And when I started with them, we only had 3 airplanes and grew it into 30-some airplanes. And yeah.
Right. Traveling everywhere.
Fun. Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
that's good.
A lot of fun. Learned a lot.
And what brought you back here?
So I met my husband in Colorado. He was working for the airlines as well. And
what
then,
a coincidence.
Isn't that amazing, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. Good people in Colorado.
Understand.
Yeah. So then I went into management with the airlines, and I started moving, transferring around, and he kept following me. And
Nice. That
good.
Works.
It did. It worked really well. So when I was in Tennessee, we were pregnant with our daughter.
Okay.
And I was 40 years old at the time of my pregnancy, so they had me do an amnio test, and I found out
because there's more risk.
There is, absolutely, yeah. So I had that test done and found out that she was going to be born with Down syndrome.
Yes.
So I didn't know what Down syndrome was. So during the research on trying to find out what all that meant,
sure.
I came across therapeutic riding, and so my connection with horses when I was younger, and love of kids and everything.
Finding out being pregnant with
yeah,
a daughter
I knew
with
instantly
Down syndrome.
That
yes.
that's what God had planned for me, so I never looked back. I just
wow.
started volunteering at various therapeutic riding centers and
yeah.
learning about how to run the business, and did some in Tennessee, did some in Florida.
Oh, okay.
And then I moved back here to start our own.
No, and I met your daughter at the Kidney Foundation, had something at Gilfallon Farm for the Always Be Smiling.
Yes.
Dean and Kristen started this great group for their son,
wonderful.
Bennett, who had two kidney transplants and died at 16 and a half. Mm-hmm. Like I tell people on my Pittsburgh Sportsline show, because I promote them, please like Always Be Smiling.
Absolutely.
And we appreciate it. I boosted them up to over 700 now likes.
That's
so
wonderful.
I'm trying to help out, and I'm going to get Kristen on a show when I have some other openings. We had an opening today for you, and I told you I'd get you on as soon as I could.
Yeah.
So I tried to keep my word, and it worked out.
It did. It worked out well.
And I have experience with people at the Meadows when I had racehorses. There were a couple ladies, I forget their names now, but they worked with handicapped children and kids with horses.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So yeah. I was familiar with that in the 80s when I owned horses.
So
it really struck a chord with me to meet you, who I heard about, you know, your horses with hope. So it's just a good thing.
It's pretty amazing things. And
how'd you come up with the name?
I just thought of it.
It just came to you?
Yeah.
Those are the best things.
Well, originally I wanted to do Horses of Hope, and there was a center on the eastern side of the state that already had that name. So I said Horses with Hope then.
And no, that's good.
I actually like that better, because horses, they give us a lot of hope, actually.
Well, you met Dave Cable, and you know him, and he told me I should interview people, and he said, come up with a name for a show.
Yeah.
So I called it the Talking Machine Show. I'm very creative.
It's perfect.
So we're on the same page.
Yeah,
I respect that.
Yeah.
Now, with time frames, how long have you been doing this? Because how old is your daughter now?
So she's 18. And we moved.
Very beautiful, nice young lady.
Oh, thank you.
Glad I met her, you know, a month ago now. So.
Yeah, she's a great kid. I could have 20 of her. She's
she's
really wonderful. And I'm very fortunate.
Just well-mannered, doing different things.
Yeah. And, you know, I think, too, there's just being the parent of a child with special needs and things. But the way Jamie is if she had more challenging health issues, I wouldn't have been able to do what I do. I wouldn't have been able to start up the
No,
program.
She seems very healthy.
Yeah, she's really good. And
how does she do with the horses?
She does good. She's not so much into them anymore because I make her work too much.
Understand. I understand.
Yeah, she's like, no, I think I'll stay home today, Mom.
Well, you're a good mother. You got to do those.
Yeah,
things.
But I used to, I usually bring her in on these types of interviews and things and let her part of the show.
She had an open invite, and she got a better offer.
I can't believe ice cream.
Ice cream over the talking machine.
What is that? I'm going to have to work on that with her.
Well, no, I'll have to work on providing ice cream.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll compete head to head.
Could have told her we'd have a chicken sandwich for her.
Well, yeah. I just bought fresh turkey, so I could have brought
that
in.
There you go, yeah.
We digress a little bit here.
Sorry, yes.
Now, how do people get a hold of you?
So our website is the best way, horseswithhope.org.
Okay.
And
just go there and contact you through that.
Yes, uh-huh. There's an email address and a phone number.
Can you
number
say
as well.
The email address?
Yes, it's Ann.
I'm testing you now.
Oh, are you? Yeah, good memory. No. Let's see if I have one. It's Ann, A-N-N-E-H-W-H, @gmail.com.
Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. You can contact her there and, you know, with special needs children and
Absolutely,
send them to her.
Yeah.
She works great with them. I saw her in action a little bit, so out there. And how large are your classes, or do you do individually counseling, does this work?
Yeah, so the therapeutic riding program is all with special needs kids and adults, and the lessons are 40 minutes long. We have up to 3 riders in every lesson.
And you prefer their parents to be there?
Usually it's their parents that will bring them, yes. Sometimes if they're older adults, they might live in group homes, and then their caregivers come.
Just wanted to know, because, you know, I'm trying to explain to people what you do.
Oh, yeah, absolutely,
yes.
Right, yes. So, and then we teach them a riding skill, and then we go down on a sensory trail. We have 3 or 4 activity sites set up down there to teach them additional skill sets.
And where's this at?
This is at Gilfillan Farm.
Okay. I want you to explain that, because when I tell people it's right near South Hills Village, they go, where?
I know. It's so hard to.
I've seen it for years.
So many people don't even know that it exists.
And it's a farm, an active farm.
Yes, it is. There's 15 acres hidden back in there around inside Gilfillan Park.
Right.
And so we just moved there 2 months ago.
I heard.
Yeah, we've been working on that project for about a year and a half.
And they have a nice trail around it that you
can
go?
They do. It's a great walking trail. It's 1.25 mile, I think, walking trail there.
The people and kids were doing it at the Kidney Foundation events.
Yes.
Because we were sitting at our table and we go, where'd everybody go? We didn't walk that day.
Yeah, we didn't. We stayed and talked.
Yes, we did. And we did well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it was a great day.
Definitely. So how many do you have, like, on an average class?
So we offer 4 sessions a year, and each session lasts between 6 and 8 weeks long.
Okay.
And we usually operate April through October.
November. Well, you want better weather.
Yes. Yeah.
I figured that out pretty quickly.
Yeah, we want better weather. Not that Pittsburgh doesn't have good weather, but I don't know.
I always say if we're not complaining about the weather, we don't live here.
Yeah, right? That is true. That is
too hot.
True. Yeah.
Too cold. No, not enough rain.
No, exactly. Yeah.
And in the wintertime, too much snow. We covered all that.
We cannot win.
So 6 to 8 week programs.
6 to 8 week programs.
And is that a weekly that they go to?
It is. Yeah, okay. They'll come the same day.
I'm trying to add into the blanks.
That's all good.
How am I doing?
Okay. You're connecting the dots really well.
Yes.
Yeah. And you're paying attention. That's more important. Yeah.
And I'm a man too.
Yeah.
Just thought I'd throw that in.
So we have nearly 50 riders that come every week.
Okay. And how many horses do you have?
Right now we have 6 horses.
Okay.
I'm sure.
Because I'm trying to explain to people that you can only send so many out at a time. 6?
6 horses. We should have 8. We're down a couple.
I was going to ask that question. You beat me to it,
Ann.
You must have experience at this.
I just brought a new one in, though, last Saturday. So we're.
And do you get to buy a certain type of horse? Do you look for certain horses or... Like me, I had the standard bred horse, mm-hmm. and we donated to a couple families of horses, and they put them in the 4-H programs, and they're a gentler, not like the thoroughbreds, and they're really easy to listen and do things. They won awards. These kids were so thankful to us that they won awards.
I've heard they do well in therapeutic riding programs as well. I've never had any in our program, but it just... because I've never had
them. They're not high strung.
Right.
I can tell you, I know how to feed the horses, hold your hand flat, let them eat the carrots, don't put the thumb up
because
their teeth are like a clamp.
Uh-huh.
They'll bite your fingers off.
Yeah.
So I know that experience, but the standard bred is just a
They're good horses. We also use quarter horses. We have
I've heard that.
The smaller draft type horses. So
We
have a Norwegian Fjord.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, and a couple halflingers.
Nice.
Yeah.
So you take a variety of horses.
I do, yeah.
And you can work with any type of horse, do you say?
Well, it depends on what the horse is like. So they definitely have to have the demeanor in order to
If they're a little
high
strung, forget about it.
Forget about it, yeah.
Because I noticed with our horses, like one horse they would call a puller. When you put him on the track, he pulls your arms out.
Mm-hmm.
But he was real docile in the stall.
Mm-hmm.
And I gave him a choice with apples. I gave him a delicious apple and a stamen apple is one of my favorites.
Yeah.
His name was Stardy Oak. I'd hand it out. He'd go to the stamen apple all the time.
Is that right?
I called it a fast apple.
Ah.
So I didn't know if you ever experienced with him, with different type of things like that.
Yeah, no.
I like to experiment and see.
Yeah, that's fun stuff. Absolutely,
Something different. And you got to buy the hay and straw.
We do, yeah.
Okay.
It's you are well aware. It's not a very cheap.
No,
program,
there's a cost. There's hard costs there. Just like the feed, they eat different feed,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
and some have vitamins and other things in them to help them out, and others are just as simple as oats.
Right.
And
yeah.
then I know about different types of grass that are actually. The hay.
In the hay,
and then hay they don't lay on, hay they eat, straw they lay on, they pee and poop on it, so you have to muck a stall.
Yes.
Right?
All
Are you good
that.
At mucking?
All of that, yes. And I think that's why Jamie doesn't come anymore.
I used to muck. Being an owner of a horse, I wanted to learn.
Yeah.
And they go, hey, you can do this anytime. I go, what about the grooms? They go, they like what you're doing.
Yeah, right, yeah. I tell you, our program runs mainly with volunteers.
Oh, really? That's great.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Now, explain this. You're a nonprofit, so I wanted to get this out.
Yes.
You're a 501c3.
Absolutely.
And for all of you, that means you're a nonprofit. If you donate $1, you can write it off. If you donate $1,000, they'll appreciate it. Thank
Absolutely.
You, and you can write that off.
Absolutely, yeah.
So Just remember, horses with hope.
If you want me to come speak at your business or anything like that, I'd be happy to promote our...
And she's answering questions before I'm asking. So call her to speak. Please have Ann speak with you.
It's good to be able to support your local charities.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. 501c3, we're
Absolutely.
Friendly to them.
Yes, thank you.
Definitely. Please donate.
And
just
we appreciate
a dollar.
That. Yes.
Just $1
just
helps.
$1. $1 a person makes a difference.
Well, I have 4,680 close friends.
There you go.
And if they're all watching, $1.
I'll be getting $4,680 soon.
Don't hold your breath.
Christmas is coming.
Yes. And you start from April, and then when do you shut down?
The end of October.
So October, you hold out till Halloween, give them trick-or-treat,
That's
and then
it.
Go.
And then we're done. So this year is a little different because we did move to Gilfillan Farm.
Sure.
And one of the reasons why we agreed to go to Gilfillan is for the exposure, so that the community can see
well,
who we
are.
Well,
how can you miss a main road location across from South Hills Village?
Yes.
And the fire department's right down the street?
It's perfect. It's so, really perfect.
Yes.
I've had my eye on that farm since I was 8 years old.
Really? Well, yeah. I've watched it all the time. Going down 19, heading that way. I've always pointed out to my kids, look at that farm. We'd see cows sometimes. We'd see corn.
Yeah.
You know, I even remember seeing goats at one time.
Yeah.
I think they had them.
Yeah, we have some now.
Yes, I heard. Do you help feed the goats?
We help feed the goats as well.
And that's the historical, the Upper St. Clair Historical Society that owns it.
It is, yeah. And they're a nonprofit as well.
Right. Another 501c3. We're on that.
Yes, we are.
Yes.
Yeah, we're good on that. Yeah.
And if you're in Upper St. Clair, go ahead and donate to your local 501c3.
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah.
So it's all good stuff.
It's really good stuff, yeah. And I think just to be able to keep that farm environment or that farm here in the middle of Upper St. Clair.
No, that's so cool in my mind to have a farm, which all this was farmland.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the
Gilfillan's owned all of it.
Right, and it's last of the Mohicans.
Right,
so
right,
so we got
yes.
that for history.
Which is wonderful,
now,
I think.
Do you have to sign a lease for it or anything
like
that? I do,
like yes.
Because
yeah.
I figured business is business.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, and it's, we've invested quite a bit just to get the farm to our standards. You know, because it didn't have a riding arena or anything like that,
and sure,
so we did that.
I saw a couple different pens there.
Yeah, so the one of them on the upper one is just an open air railing.
Because I saw about eight horses there. Cause
oh well,
when we were there on that day,
maybe the mini horses. You
yeah,
were
that's
yeah.
what I was going to bring up
yeah.
about the mini horses.
Yeah,
were there.
Yeah, we have the mini horses.
No, they were cute. They're
yeah.
always cool.
David
horses.
And Goliath.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Wow. Keep
yeah.
David away from Goliath.
Yeah, right, exactly.
We know what happened there.
We do know what happened. Well, I hope you know what happened.
Yes. Well, some of us do.
Some of us do.
Some may
yeah.
have forgotten.
So the other pad, though, is for we have an ongoing fundraising thing to be able to get a covered round pen.
Tell them what it is.
It's for a covered round pen. So we need to have an area. Being on a historical property, we're not allowed to actually build permanent structures.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
They
so
want to keep the natural habitat.
They
that's
do,
there.
Yeah. So a round pen.
And when's
cover,
this fundraiser starting? Is it now?
It's, can it's they ongoing.
Can it, they donate now? Explain
they can.
The fundraiser.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And
so
what is it called?
If you go to our website, it'll pop right on up and it'll say, join us in trying to accommodate to meet the needs for the funding.
I'm
on
trying
that.
To get the good word out.
I appreciate that. I really do.
Okay,
yeah,
well,
because
now you know
there.
You have a reason.
Yes.
To donate to help Ann get this area.
And the reason why we need it is because it never rains in Pennsylvania.
Okay, good
so,
point.
Yeah, so when it does rain, we wouldn't have to cancel the riding program.
Okay,
yeah.
So you can continue with your 6 to 8 week program.
Absolutely.
Do you take a break between the 6 or 8 weeks, or do you
take
just
a week off?
I was wondering how you mm-hmm. operated, because if you roll right in there.
Yeah, the horses, you know, it's stressful work for the horses because
sure.
the riders are all uneven. They make
well,
a lot
working.
Of different noises.
They're actually
yeah,
working.
They are,
and
absolutely.
They're great athletes, but every athlete needs a break.
Absolutely.
That's what I
yeah.
learned with the horse racing business.
Yeah, yeah.
And they are great athletes. Look at the shape they're in.
Yeah, and we try to do other things with them, too, so that it's not just work. So,
like what do you,
know,
do?
So like going on trail rides and things like that. We do a lot of natural horsemanship skills on the ground with them
okay.
and get them their mind thinking on other things.
Oh,
and,
sure,
yeah, so.
Sure, because you're trying to expand their horizons.
Yes, absolutely, yeah.
And so that
speaking
helps
of that.
Yes. Carry on.
Speaking talking about. Our original location is on a farm, a 93-acre farm in Bethel Park off of Clifton Road on Brush Run Road.
Yes.
And that, our landlord there has agreed to allow us to keep that property.
Oh, good. And congrats.
So, because we do mental health work as well with the horses.
Oh, really?
Everything on the ground, yeah. So we work with ARC of Washington County. We work with Southwood Psychiatric Hospital. We work with many schools.
How's that work?
They bring us a group of kids or adults. And
what do you do?
So it's an interaction, experiential type of therapy with the horses. So say we're the word of the day is going to be trust that we're working on. So they'll come in. We talk about the word trust and what it means to every individual there.
Sure.
And then we'll have a scenario with the horses that they have to go into, whether it be leading the horse through an obstacle course and if the horse balks or if it doesn't want to follow you, you know, and how do you react with that?
Sure. I have a question to interrupt you with mm-hmm. that. With people being around large animals, sometimes they're very fearful of mm-hmm. the horses. Mm-hmm. And like when I owned horses, we had kids that were young kids just crawling around. They said, you can let them in the stall and they won't mess with them.
Right, yeah.
And I found out my 3-year-old daughter was in there in the stall.
Really?
Petting the horse.
Aw. So, they do know. They're very intuitive. So a horse
And their brain's only the size of a walnut.
I know, but I tell you
but
what.
But they're smarter than some people
I
know.
Yeah,
especially
absolutely.
In this day and age.
That's why
just
I like
my
working
opinion.
With them.
Just my opinion.
That's why I got out of the airline industry, yeah.
Yes. Yes, but I just wondered, are they hesitant when they come into the group to go up to a horse, or do you see that once in a while?
It varies. It all varies
well,
on their
like personalities.
Yeah, with their personalities.
And what do you do then, like in that situation?
Then
like
we
somebody
just take it slower.
Okay.
Yeah, but eventually they'll come. And
you break them down.
Yeah. Mm-hmm, yeah.
No,
yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, so it's all good stuff on that. But, you know, these types of scenarios with the horses, it's called equine-assisted learning. So we teach them a basic life skill that they're working on, so trust, honesty, respect, communication.
And that's the word of the day.
Yeah, it's the word of the day.
And the theme.
And the theme, yeah. And then they have, usually they'll have a licensed mental health person that comes with the group.
I would hope so, yes.
And then they can use what they learn at our farm and carry it over in their daily life.
Okay.
Whether it be in school.
So it does help them, and you're having some success with it,
absolutely.
I assume.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yes,
And
absolutely.
People need it. Look what's going on in our country, the mental health issues that are developing
it's
and
huge.
Getting worse.
It's,
yes.
It's humongous. I've had so many phone calls this year alone for, you know, teenagers that with the anxiety or the depression. And
well, look at the change in school.
It's horrible.
And not going to school.
It's really horrible.
And no social interaction.
Right, right.
It's, so get a hold of Horses with Hope.
Yeah, come on.
It'll give you hope. And my youngest sister's name is Hope.
Is that right?
Yes.
Oh.
I have Joy, Judy, and Hope. They always said, where's Faith?
You were supposed to be.
No, I was the first one out.
Oh, that's right.
They came later. I was Alan. That's my story.
I love it.
It means something, Horses with Hope, with me.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah,
yeah,
it does.
There's a good connection there.
It's perfect.
I love it.
Hand in a glove here.
Absolutely.
And
yeah.
What do you look forward to the future with what you're doing? Continuing what you're doing, or are
yeah,
you going to expand?
Expanding,
or?
Yeah. So I'm hoping this time.
I'm hopeful that it is.
Yeah, absolutely. So I want to use the Brush Run location for just the mental health.
I got
and,
you.
And so
separate there.
Separate
and then
there.
Go
and
to
do
Gilfallen.
The therapeutic riding for Gilfallen. Yes. And then so we're looking for new instructors.
I was going to ask.
Yep. Yeah, it takes about a year to get your certification. We're not just
you
know,
you get certified
we
with
get
the
certified,
state.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure. I wanted
yeah.
to ask. So you have what certifications
so
do you have?
All of us are certified as therapeutic riding instructors through an organization called PATH, PATH International.
Okay.
And they're based out of Denver. And
again, your Colorado connection.
There it is. Your Colorado
strong.
Connection.
Strong.
I'm telling you.
You're the best.
Yeah. Yeah. So we're all certified through that, and then we also are dual certified through another organization. This won't just stay up.
No, that's all right.
It's all right.
If it goes down a little, don't worry.
All right. The other organization is called EGALA, and it's an acronym for Equine Assisted.
Yeah, spell it.
So E-A-G-A-L-A.
Okay, EGALA.
And it stands for Equine Assisted Growth and Learning Association.
We needed that mouthful
I'm
out
there. I'm telling you.
Yes. Yeah. Well, you're getting help.
We are, absolutely, yeah. So we are certified as equine specialists, so we understand the movements and the behaviors of the horses, and as they interact with humans, we work with alongside that mental health professional.
And do you see, like, growth there, like when they start the first day, that they keep improving and you can
absolutely.
Do more and more things with them?
It's incredible. It really is.
I've heard that. That's
it's
why.
It's just amazing. I'm just in awe, really.
Don't you feel great when you're helping people?
I love it. I think we get to see little miracles every single day. That's the way I look at it.
And you're such a positive person like I am, and I appreciate helping others.
Yes.
Hence the show, to get the word out about Horses with Hope.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Well, we're getting down to the last few minutes.
Yeah.
Do you have any other points that maybe we didn't go over that you'd like to cover there? Like, if somebody had a horse they wanted to donate, could they get a hold of you to do that?
They can get a hold of us, yes. I'll say one thing, though. I want you to clarify. Yeah, if they have health issues, we really won't accept a horse with health issues.
Understand.
Because it usually costs us a lot of money.
Well, the point of it is you're a nonprofit and money's tight,
right.
And you're helping other people that need it.
Absolutely, yeah.
But I just wanted to put it out there, so if somebody's thinking about it, maybe somebody was given a horse like we did with other people,
mm-hmm, yeah.
What do you do next? Like, the girls in this family grew up, so they donated the horse to a retirement home out at the Meadows.
Oh, good.
They had a field there, so he lived a nice long life out
there.
Where the older people got to pet the horse and feed him stamen apples.
Hey, I think that's a wonderful thing. I'd love to be able to take our minis into the retirement communities as well.
I just thought that was cool.
It's like limitless what you could do with them, really.
Oh, sure.
If you had enough. So we're looking for, in the future, we do need some more horses. We also need...
That's why I brought it up.
Thank you. We need a truck and a trailer to be able to take the horses back and forth and go to various shows and things like that. And
yes.
then we need instructors. But we're growing. So if you have any interest, give me a call. Shoot me an email.
Go to the website.
Go to the website.
Don't give a call. She's not giving out her number. I know her secret number, and I can keep secrets, so I'm not telling it.
Thank you.
And, if any of the horse people that I know that have a trailer that maybe you're going to get rid of and trade, maybe you can work something out with Ann here.
That'd be great.
She's willing to negotiate, and she's looking for cheap.
Absolutely.
But something quality.
Quality.
We need quality first.
We do, yes.
Those horse trailers, they're always cool. I always like seeing the horses in them.
Yes, yeah.
And
absolutely.
We had a couple horses that balked about getting into the trailer,
mm-hmm,
which
yeah.
they do. They all
yes,
their
they
personalities.
Do. You got to watch their heads, right?
Yes, yeah. Definitely. No doubt about it.
Well, it's been a pleasure. I really appreciate, again, you having me on here. And
you're so welcome.
Letting your watchers know more about Horses with Hope.
Yes, yes. We learned a bunch, and I hope all of you enjoyed our show here. This is Ann Davis with Horses with Hope, a 501c3 nonprofit, and she's helping handicapped children and mental patients,
mm-hmm.
and it's all certified. They're all very well trained.
Yep.
And just go to her website, horseswithhope.org.
Yes.
See,
you're
I remembered that.
Good. Yeah.
On that happy note, hope you enjoyed the show. Ann, thank you so much for being
a
great guest.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
And continued success with all that you do.
Thank you.